You use a password manager, but are you taking full advantage of it? I'm gonna share with you 6 things you should be doing with your password manager to help you build even greater privacy and security. This video is sponsored by trendmicro, more on them in a moment. Let's jump into these 6 important password tips most people ignore, including the last one, which is a critical step that most people miss. For some people, the idea of storing all of your online logins in one place behind a single master password is frankly frightening, and I get it. Is it really secure to put all of your eggs in one basket? So to anybody who's had this concern, I have a simple solution for you that I think you're gonna like. I call it the double blind password, but it's sometimes called password salting or peppering. It works like this. Let's say my password manager provides a strong, unique password for my bank login. This is what gets stored in the password manager. But what gets set with the bank is actually this password plus some additional word, phrase, or number that you or I can come up with. Now, when I want to log into the bank website, I have my password manager autofill the password it has stored, and then I type in the additional characters. This removes the risk of keeping all of your logins in one place because your password manager doesn't actually store your full password. Now, I don't do this for all of my logins, but it is a really good strategy to use for those logins that you want to keep most secure. Using email aliases with a password manager is a game changer. If you're like most people, you probably use the same email or username for most online logins. And for the longest time, I know that's what I did because I didn't know any better. But creating unique aliases for your logins does 2 things. First, it makes your online security that much stronger because a hacker doesn't just have to guess one part of your login, the password, they now have to guess both your username and your password. Second, if that particular company experiences a data breach or they sell your email for marketing purposes, you're not at risk because you can easily deactivate that alias. Now, I've already done a video on email aliases, so if you want to learn how to do that, you can watch that next. Is your password manager protected by 2-factor authentication? Now, I'm not talking about storing your 2FA codes for your logins. I'm talking about what's required for you to log in to use the password manager itself. Now, this feature isn't available with every password manager, but if it is, I recommend you use it. I have an authenticator code and 2 security keys that I use with my password manager, which means that anytime a new device tries to access my password vault, not only will I need to enter my login credentials like normal, I'll also be asked for a second set of verification, which I'll probably use those 2FA keys. As with any kind of login, if you can use 2FA for added security, you should. Your password manager is no different. And if you really want to level up to maximum security for you and your family, you should check out this week's sponsor, trendmicro. Their premium security suite includes protection, not just for your PC, Mac, and mobile devices. It also includes things like Wi-Fi protection, dark web monitoring, and yes, even a password manager if you're not already using one. I've used this to scan all of my devices and to protect myself against malicious websites, apps, and even all kinds of ransomware. The best part is that it is really easy to set up and use. It just kind of works seamlessly in the background of any device. Learn more about their premium security suite in the link in the description and use code ATS10 to get 10% off of your purchase. You know those security questions that you're sometimes required to answer? Usually it's something like, what is your mother's maiden name? What was the name of your first pet? Or what street did you grow up on? There's a big problem with these kind of questions that I'm sure you know. The answers are usually not that hard to find out. All it takes is a little bit of sleuthing on social media or publicly available records to find out all of this information. Thankfully, a password manager can solve this problem. Next time you get asked to provide answers to these questions, just make up random answers. What's your mother's maiden name? Bumfuzzle. What was the model of your first car? I don't know, Bob Dylan. Store these random answers in the notes section of your password login so that you can easily find it when you need it. And sure, you could just use the same wrong answers for the same questions, but it's just as easy to make up new ones for each login that requires it, so that's completely up to you. A chain is only as strong as its weakest link, right? And unfortunately, when it comes to online security, that weakest link is usually a family member. I'm glad you have a strong password for your bank login, but if your spouse has their own login to the same account with a password that isn't nearly as strong, guess what? your security isn't as good as you might think. Getting your family invested in your overall security is not an easy task, I know. But the best place to start is to share a password manager vault where strong passwords are stored. Start by helping them download and install a password manager on their computer or mobile device. That's step one. Then start storing the passwords that your family shares in that vault. Things like your streaming video passwords, your Amazon password, and so on and so forth. You want to create strong reasons for them to use the password manager without forcing them to do so, because we all know how well that works. Finally, help them create a stronger password for a set of key logins that you would really like to have locked down. Step by step, building up your online security and helping them along the way. Last but not least, and this is a critical step that I'm surprised most people don't do, you need to download, print, or store your emergency access file. Think about this. If something were to suddenly happen to you, how easy would it be for your family members or the executor of your estate to access your accounts? I mean, maybe you don't want them to have access right now, but in the case of an emergency, there needs to be some way for them to gain access. And that's where an emergency access file comes in handy. For some password managers, this is a file that you can download, print, and keep, let's say, with your will. For other managers, it's a secret key or a key phrase. Whatever it is, it's worth having a printed copy kept in a safe or, again, along with your final will with your lawyers or something. Thanks again to Trend Micro for sponsoring this video. Learn more about their premium security suite in the link below this video. And if you've heard all this stuff about how we're moving away from passwords to this new standard called a passkey, watch this video next if you want to learn more.